Hey everybody, I'm Dr. Richard Stevenson and I'm the Director of Education at Stevenson Dental Solutions. I'm also Emeritus Professor of Clinical Dentistry at UCLA. And this is our teaching center where we conduct many hands-on courses all year long. So today, guys, I'm going to talk about the 5x5x5 technique for all ceramic crown preps as it pertains to a maxillary central incisor. We're going to work on tooth number 8 today. And this is the Kilgore type, and you can see that sometimes the occlusion is not really socked in. This happens, you know, after you've had a typodont for a few years and you're putting teeth in and out, you can sometimes have these discrepancies. No worries, we're going to take this into consideration when we prepare the tooth. The first step is incisal reduction. Let's go ahead and use a 330 diamond. This is one of the two depth cutting burrs that's in the system. We like this because it's 2 millimeters long and we can make a nice little slit right across the incisal to create the appropriate amount of incisal reduction. At this point, you're going to want to remove the tooth structure between the pages, and I like using the 6856016. You know, when you have a 6 in front of a diamond, it means that the grit on the diamond is 125 microns, so we consider that to be coarse. If it doesn't have a stripe on it, then it's 100 microns. And so we just remove the tooth structure that's between the little slits, leave a little flange here on the end, because we're going to remove that in a further step. So let's go to step 2, which is lingual clearance, and we're going to use the same burr. I mean, why not? It's still in the handpiece. It's a great burr for this, and we're trying to get to 1.5 millimeters of lingual clearance when we look up at the tooth at an angle. So we want to look at it, you know, like this, up at about a 30 or 40 degree angle. If you don't have an instrument to measure with, you can use the shank of a burr, which is 1.6 millimeters. Pretty cool trick. Now let's move on to axial reduction. On axial reduction, this is the longest step. This is the step where we're going to use the same diamond once again. And you can see the green stripe there. And I like the fact that at the tip, you go 1 millimeter, and at the widest part near the shank, you're going to go about 1.5 millimeters. So the burr, in a way, is ideally shaped to create this gradually increased amount of clearance, or more appropriately, reduction that we can do on the facial surface. And we're going to utilize the technique I've shown before, where you leave a little bit of tooth structure in the middle unprepared. And the reason for that is it provides you with like a built-in putty stent. If we were allowed to take an impression of this with putty and then slice the putty mesial distally or facial lingually, we could apply that putty back onto the preparation and we could compare our reduction to the original surface. Well, we're not able to do that in all situations, certainly not on exams. And so what we're going to do here is we're going to leave that little portion on the distal side for a while to give us an idea of how much we've reduced. It's actually a really helpful technique. Some of you might be a little bit taken aback by the fact that I'm using the 6856 to go interproximally, but you know, this is an all ceramic crown preparation, and our goal here today is to make a 1 millimeter 360 degree fillet finish line. And 1 millimeter is pretty aggressive and certainly not what you would do on every case, but let's just call it the standard go-to prep. In other words, if you're taking a test someplace and they don't tell you any parameters for the all ceramic, they don't say, oh, we want to have the facial margin 0.6 or 0.8. We don't have any information on exactly how we're going to prep the tooth. We can rely on this standard where you have a 1 millimeter 360 degree shoulder with a rounded internal, otherwise known as a fillet margin. And then you're going to be in great shape. And that'll work for all materials. Now, clinically, we like to do these preparations as conservatively as possible to meet both the aesthetic and functional demands of the case. And oftentimes that means that we can be as little as half a millimeter of reduction and treat it almost like a bonded veneer. When you're breaking interproximal contact with a thick burr like this, as long as you know how deep you're going to need to be axially, you can do this with confidence. It really doesn't take a lot of courage to do this if you understand that the burr has to be positioned pretty far axially to have that 1 millimeter requirement. If we are going to be preparing these teeth more conservatively, we're going to want to use a more narrow diameter burr. So this is the T-prep design you can see because it's a tenon which has been left behind. This is a term that's used in furniture building, woodworking. A tenon is a protrusion out of a piece of lumber, for example, or wood, that will lock into a dovetail area or lock into a mortise. And this is why we call it the T-prep. And you're going to see here that you can use that little stripe down the middle as a really good tool to see how much you've taken away and if you need to do any further reduction. Looks pretty good. There's some roughness and some irregularities, but take a look here. Just grab a pencil and try to trace the outline there between the tenon and the facial surface, and you can see how it gets gradually wider in terms of reduction, increases in reduction as it goes from gingival to the incisal. That's kind of a cool technique to determine how much you've reduced without having to worry about putting a putty matrix back on the tooth. And then we just remove that tenon when we are convinced that we've reduced enough. And this isn't really hard to do. You just kind of work your way down. It seems to work better when you do it from top down rather than trying to remove it from the side or something like that. You make less mistakes. And at this point, I think we're in pretty good shape for the basic preparation on the facial, and we should turn our attention to the lingual axial. And once again, just burying the tip of the burr into approximately a millimeter and keeping the burr upright and allowing the burr's taper to create the overall taper that we need on the preparation. And working that all the way around. I know a lot of you are thinking, wow, this looks easy on the benchtop, but in the mouth, it's a lot harder. And I understand where you're coming from, but I actually think it's easier to do this in the mouth and on the mannequin than it is to do it on the benchtop, where I have to stretch my arms out to get it underneath the camera. I think it's much easier to have the mannequin holding the Typonaut and use the mirror to make these preparations. Let's do step 4, which is the phosphor reduction. And for this, we have to understand that the same burr, 6856, we're going to use the tip of this burr to create a 1 millimeter reduction. You can make it a little bit deeper near the cingulum area, but it definitely needs to be 1 millimeter. And you notice that I'm not touching that upper 2 millimeters of the lingual, because that is the lingual portion that was already reduced in step number 2. So let me show you here with a pencil. I'm going to outline the area that has already been reduced right here. So when you go to do your lingual fossa, don't touch this area with these three X's on it. Just leave that alone and make your reduction in the area gingival to that. And so for this, we like using the KS5 teardrop burr. It's really fast. And you know, this technique really is a 5-minute prep. And I think that it's a 5-minute prep that is excellent for all ceramic, and it's going to make your laboratories very happy. You can certainly be more conservative, but it's kind of cool to get things done quickly and nicely with this technique. We're doing the refinement, and the first burr I use, since I'm already working at the lingual, is this 8379, which is a red stripe large football, and that does it pretty quickly. And then we're going to use a 8856, which is the partner to the 6856. And the difference is this is a fine grit. So the grit size on this burr is only 30 microns compared to the 125 microns you'll find on the 6856016. While we're here, I just might want to mention that a burr that has a black stripe on it would be considered to be extra coarse, and those burrs have a 5 as their first number. So it would be the 5856, and the grit on those is 150 microns. Once you understand what these colored stripe means, it can be really helpful for how to set up your own burr blocks in your practice and make things more efficient. And we're just once again going around and smoothing off the finish line. If we see a J shape, we take the rounded edge of this and just kind of move it off a little bit and remove it that way. Some people like to use end cutting burrs for this purpose. I don't think that they're necessary. I think you can do a nice job of removing J-shaped areas when you understand that you can just run this burr off the edge and remove the J-shape in that particular manner. Perhaps you can use a low speed or an electric handpiece and turn the speed down considerably to make the preparation really, really fine. It looks like it's coming along. It's a little crude at this point, but we I think we're ready to move into the refinement phase because we have the dimensions established. And I'm going to utilize the Composite Pro wheel. We have a cup and a wheel made by Brassler for this 5x5x5 kit. We're just calling it the 5x5 because it's basically five burr steps with five different burrs for each preparation, and the other five would be 5 minutes. So some people were like, wait a minute, I can't do it in 5 minutes yet. So maybe we'll just call this the 5x5 technique from here on forward. But we're just playing around with some ideas. Let me know what you think in the comments. And I appreciate your comments. I would like to see some more. That let me know what kind of preps you want me to do and how I can help you in your journey towards excellence in dentistry. Let's take a look at this prep as it's finished here and take a look at the clearance underneath. You can see that it's a lot more than it was originally, hopefully, in this 1.6 millimeter shank of a burr wiggles a little bit, so that makes sense because we want to have about 1.5 clearance there. And we had some clearance to begin with. So it's been fun, pretty short time here together, but I hope you enjoyed this video. And let me know what you think, and I'll talk to y'all soon. Take care. Bye.